Voices of Vista.
Someone who's willing, someone to care, someone who's needed and glad to be there, someone to give of himself for a year.
With Dick Manning and the John Cacavas Orchestra and Chorus. These are the voices of Vista, volunteers in service to America. All over America, in slums, migrant worker camps, Indian reservations, wherever opportunity is needed. That's where Vista volunteers go.
Someone who's young and someone who's old, hands that are willing and hearts that are bold. Someone to give what is priceless and dear, a Vista volunteer. Vista volunteer. Vista volunteer.
I'm Willis Conover. Now meet our guest. Dick Manning.
Thank you, Willis. It's a real pleasure to be on Voices of Vista today.
Thank you for joining us. Music is your life, Dick. How did it happen?
Well, very naturally. I come from theatrical folk. My father was a producer of shows and felt that I should be a musician. So that's how I began. Actually, what I can say why I got into the business of composing is probably because I was rather reluctant to practice. I hated to practice. And I was very arrogant about Haydn and Mozart and Beethoven. I felt, well, they weren't born with any better brains than I, and they were the guys who invented music, and why couldn't I invent music? So I recomposed them instead of practicing, and that's how I got into composition and got into songwriting. And along the line, studied at Juilliard, studied accompanying, studied composition, and I picked up orchestration and arranging by actual sweat, by myself.
Well, may we have a demonstration, Dick?
Well, one of the things that is very dear to me is a composition which was inspired by the flight of the Friendship 7 by Colonel John Glenn. And I wrote this thing, orchestrated it, and sent copies to Mr. Glenn, and later had it recorded by the London Record Company. And
this is the music John Cacavas is ready to play now?
Yes, there it is.
Dick Manning's song, The Flight of Friendship 7.
Thank you.
Flight of Friendship 7 by Dick Manning, our voice for Vista. Dick will be back in just a moment. Poverty isn't easy to understand. When people say, let them get jobs, let them be like us, they mean it, but they just don't understand. But we're trying. Trying to make it possible for every American to share the blessings. And that's what Vista is all about. Vista is people like you, spending one full year living away from home, living where there is poverty, an Indian reservation, a city slum, a migrant worker camp. Uncle Sam pays expenses and saves up $50 a month for the Vista volunteer when his year is over. Yes, you live right there with the people you are helping. You learn something, they learn something. Vista, volunteers in service to America. For information, write to Vista, Box C, Washington, D.C. Our voice for Vista, composer, lyricist, Dick Manning. Dick, how old were you when your first song was published?
Well, I think that the first song was published in 1944.
Well, now, the next piece of music with a Dick Manning byline, what's its story?
Christmas is a birthday has been a cherished idea of mine for a long time, and I never found a tune to write it to. It always seemed to me around Christmas time that too many people forgot that Christmas was a birthday. And so when I got this melody, which incidentally was written by ASCAP's youngest composer, the son of the violinist Emery Deutsch, Gregory Deutsch, I set the words of Christmas as a birthday to the young man's melody, and I prepared it in a choral arrangement, which John can do, and I think you'll like it.
Dick Manning's Christmas is a Birthday. Christmas is a Birthday by our guest, Dick Manning. He'll be back in a moment. Now, on the phone from Denver, Colorado, a Vista volunteer named Ruth Johnson. Ruth, why did you join Vista?
Well, because I've always wanted to work close with people. Also, I'd had some reverses in my own life where I needed help badly and received it. And this was one way for me to try to repay and also do something that I enjoyed doing.
Well, what did you find when you got there?
Well, I found a great deal of need. I think even just being a friend to the families that I work with has meant something, probably just as much to me as it has to them. They're very appreciative of anything you can do for them. And there have been many things, I think, that a Vista worker can do. For one thing, I think it's as close as anything will ever come to a one-to-one program, where you work close with a family for a whole year. You know, even though you have a number of families, you still get to know everyone real well.
Well, Ruth, could Vista use more people like you?
Yes, I think it needs people. I think you have to recognize the fact that, you know, you might be disappointed many times, and even get depressed sometimes because you can't seem to change things as much as you'd like to. But there's something, you get as much out of it as you could ever put into it because there's something so good about helping people. You know, I mean, you feel good.
Thank you, Ruth. Keep up the good work. Ruth Johnson, a Vista volunteer. Our voice for Vista is Dick Manning. Dick, I see you're listed as having written the song La Plume De Ma Tante. Was this written for the Broadway show of the same name, or what?
La Plume De Ma Tante, Willis, followed the run of the Broadway show, or rather ran concurrent with it. We had seen the show, and there was no song called La Plume de Ma Tante in it, except something like 16 measures of the chorus of the people in the review taking their bows, but there was no song. And this La Plume de Ma Tante, bit of this phrase, had intrigued me for a long time. We used to fool around with it when we were studying French. And, you know, a plume de ma tante, the pen of my aunt is on the bureau of my uncle, and so on and so forth. So we wrote this bit of nonsense about la plume de ma tante, kidded about it, and sold it on the street. John remembers, Hugo and Luigi were doing a lot of children's chorus stuff at that time, and we met these characters in front of Lindy's. And just standing there, sang them the La Plume de Ma Tante thing. They liked it and went into the studio immediately and recorded it. And they have a children's chorus that John can demonstrate here in La Plume de Ma Tante, which pretty well illustrates the idea that we had. It was done very much the way we wrote it.
All right, let's hear it again.
La, 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 la.
La Plume de Ma Tante.
La 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 la.
La 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 la. La 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 la.
La 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 la.
La plume de ma tante. Et c'est la bureau de mon oncle.
Bureau de mon oncle.
La papier de mon oncle. Et c'est la bureau de ma tante.
Bureau de ma tante.
Which means the pen of my aunt.
Bureau of my uncle.
The paper of my uncle is on the bureau of my aunt.
Bureau of my aunt.
If you don't parle bon français, then this will be Greek to you. If you can't figure out what the words are all about, just sing la 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 loo. The papier de mon oncle, et c'est le bureau de ma tante.
Bureau de ma tante.
Which means the pen of my aunt is on the bureau of my uncle.
Bureau of my uncle.
The paper of my uncle is on the bureau of my aunt.
Bureau of my aunt. La 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 la
la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la
la la la la la
la la la la plume de ma tante. Et c'est le bureau de mon oncle.
Bureau de mon oncle.
Le papier de mon oncle. Et c'est le bureau de ma tante.
Dick Manning's La Plume de Ma Tante.
Willis, if I may interject, your conversation with the Vista volunteer reminds me of how important other people's help can be. I think, I know, that whatever success I may have had in my career has definitely been through the help of so many other people in so many parts of the world. Now, for instance, there were some songs of mine that did not have any success in America whatsoever, for whatever reason. Perhaps the recording was not right, perhaps it was not the right time, and so on. But a few of those, having gone over to England through the efforts of English artists and an English publisher, did become number one over there and spread to other parts of the world, and some of them did become hits in America, but even those that didn't did well in other parts of the world. So I am very, very conscious of the fact that everyone is dependent on someone else for help. You never know where and what a good word may help you, or where somebody goes out of their way to help you. And so I'm all for the work of Vista.
You can help someone somewhere in America through Vista. Write for details. Address Vista, V-I-S-T-A, Box C, Washington, D.C. Our voice for Vista is Dick Manning. And Dick, I'm looking forward to perhaps your best-known song, Fascination.
Willis, Fascination, the tune of Fascination, has been in existence as a salon piece since 1904 or 1905, and never stepped out of that category. And about 9 years previous to the making of a picture called Love in the Afternoon, with Gary Cooper and Audrey Hepburn and Maurice Chevalier, I had written a lyric to Fascination. And for 9 years, religiously every year, the professional manager of the music publishing firm took the song under his arm, dutifully went around to the record companies, and for 9 years, everybody in the record companies turned it down and said, it's too rangy, no singer can sing it, take it back. And nothing happened with it, but I believed in it. And so every year I would come up and again religiously say, take the song around, and they would come back and say no. So we had a whole string of no's. Suddenly, one day, I heard that Fascination was being used in a film. And within 2 weeks' time, there was tremendous excitement on Broadway because the tune of Fascination was played about 40 times as a sort of running gag in the picture by a gypsy outfit, violin, cymbalom, celli, and so on. And the next thing I knew, within 2 weeks' time, where the song had been refused by everybody for 9 years, within 2 weeks' time, we had 14 records on it. Now I think there are about 1,400.
Dick Manning's Fascination.
Thank you.
thanks to our guest, composer, lyricist, Dick Manning.
Thank you, Willis, and it was really a pleasure to be here on Voices of Vista, which is doing such a marvelous job.
And our thanks to the American Federation of Musicians and to this station for making the program possible.
Someone who's willing, someone to care, someone who's needed and glad to be there, someone to give of himself for a year.
Voices of Vista is produced by Arch Lustberg for the Office of Economic Opportunity. The audio engineer was Joe Bouguer. Find out more about Vista. Write to Vista, Box C, Washington, D.C. Now for Dick Manning, the John Cacavas Orchestra and Chorus, and Willis Conover. Goodbye.
Someone who's young and someone who's old, hands that are willing and hearts that are bold. Someone to give what is priceless and dear, a Vista volunteer. Vista volunteer. Vista volunteer.
This is an M.A. Mangum production.